some aspects of carbohydrate and lipid metabolism in obese and diabetic rates. Erythropoietin is a glycoprotein hormone produced primarily in the adult kidney and secreted into the circulation to regulate red blood cell production in the bone marrow. Erythropoietin stimulates erythroid progenitor cell survival, proliferation, and differentiation. Erythropoietin reduces the regulation of red blood cell production by its specific cell surface receptor. Erythropoietin receptor expression has been detected in non-erythroid cells, including endothelial cells, epicardial and brain cells, as well as pancreatic beta cells. So it's not surprising that erythropoietin treatment can exert several non-hematopoietic effects, among which its tissue protective effect. Erythropoietin plays a role in promoting tissue protection through antioxidant, anti-apoptotic, regenerative, and angiogenic means in a variety of disease models. Erythropoietin administration to diabetic chronic renal disease patients have shown that erythropoietin significantly improves several metabolic parameters, including fasting, glucose level, and insulin sensitivity. Obesity is characterized by chronic low-grade systemic inflammation. Levels of inflammatory markers such as C-reactive protein, interleukin, and the tumor necrotic factor alpha are systemically raised in obese human. Also, prolonged duration of hyperglycemia in diabetes is associated with oxidative stress injury. So, administration of antioxidant drug, elevated glucose concentration offer protective effect. Erythropoietin may offer an attractive alternative therapy to maintain proper cellular metabolism through its cytoprotective effect. Aim of the work. The aim of the present work is to study the effect of erythropoietin on some aspects of carbohydrate and lipid metabolism in obese and diabetic rates. Material and method. The present work was carried on 50 female Western albino rats. The animals were categorized into 5 groups, 10 rats in each group as a follow. First group, control group, the animals of this group were injected intracontinually by 1 ml saline for 5 weeks. Second group, obese group, after induction of obesity, the rats of this group were injected by 1 ml saline intracontinually for 5 weeks. Third group, diabetic group, after induction of diabetes, the rats of this group were injected by 1 ml saline intracontinually for 5 weeks. Fourth group, erythropoietin treated obese group, after induction of obesity, the rats of this group were injected intracontinually with erythropoietin in a dose of 600 units per kg once daily every other day for 5 weeks. Fifth group, erythropoietin treated obese group, erythropoietin-treated diabetic group, after induction of diabetes, the rats of this group were injected intraperitoneally with erythropoietin in a dose of 600 units per kg once daily every other day for 5 weeks. At the end of the experimental period, the following parameters were measured. Fasting glucose level, glycosylated hemoglobin, serum insulin, insulin resistance, insulin sensitivity, serum low-density lipoprotein cholesterol, serum high-density lipoprotein cholesterol, serum triglyceride, total cholesterol level, and body mass index. Results. The effect of erythropoietin intraperitoneally injected on the studied parameter in obese and diabetic rats. Effect on fasting glucose level. This figure showed that the fasting glucose was significantly decreased in both erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group and erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Effect on glycosylated hemoglobin. It is clear from this figure that glycosylated hemoglobin was significantly decreased in erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. While in the erythropoietin-treated obese group, it showed no change when compared with the obese group. Effect on serum insulin level. It is clear from this figure that serum insulin significantly decreased in the erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group. While it was insignificantly changed in the erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Effect on insulin resistance. It is clear from this figure that insulin resistance significantly decreased in the erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group, while there was insignificant change in the erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Effect on insulin sensitivity. It is clear from this figure that insulin sensitivity significantly increased in the erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group, while there was insignificant change in the erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Effect on serum low-density lipoprotein level. It is clear from this figure that serum low-density lipoprotein was significantly decreased in the erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group, while it was insignificantly changed in the erythropoietin diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Effect on high-density lipoprotein. It is clear from this figure that high-density lipoprotein was significantly increased in the erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group, while it was insignificantly changed in the erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Effect on serum triglyceride. It is clear from this figure that serum triglyceride was significantly decreased in both erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group and in erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Effect on total cholesterol level. It is clear from this figure that total cholesterol was significantly decreased in the erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group, while it was insignificantly changed in the erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Finally, effect on the body mass index. It is clear from this figure that body mass index was significantly decreased in erythropoietin-treated obese group when compared with obese group, while it was insignificantly changed in the erythropoietin-treated diabetic group when compared with diabetic group. Conclusion. We conclude that erythropoietin has significant role in the regulation of carbohydrate lipid metabolism shown from its effect on glucose, insulin, and serum lipid. Also, erythropoietin administration to obese rat may have the potential goal to promote weight loss, which could be due to overcoming insulin resistance as a target tissue. The current study exemplifies an existing potential application for erythropoietin as an adjuvant anti-diabetic obesity drug to reduce blood glucose level and attenuate weight gain. Obviously, introducing erythropoietin for this indication would require additional basic research, as well as clinical trials. The idea that erythropoietin acts on glucose metabolism places this hormone in a new and most important area with significant clinical application in diabetes and obesity. Thank you.